So, time for another tying video, proper one, and I'm gonna do a live after. But in this video, we're gonna tie a pattern called Springtime. It's in the back of the Pryce Tannat book. I think it's from, let me see, can it be Veniard or? Yeah, it doesn't matter, let's just do it. Okay, first time at this pattern, Springtime. And the hook I'm tying on, of course, it's Graham Culley's 5-0 that he makes for me. Great hook, I like it a lot. So, first step, gold tinsel. So, just tying it in. Securing it with a few wraps with the thread. Then I think I go with like 3 turns or something here. 1. Or maybe I go with 4. Just go backwards with the thread. And then tie it in. Not too much. But somewhere there. I'm just gonna cut the leftovers. Computer is going wild, so I might need to. I'm just gonna pause here and change some settings. So let's see if it's better. I don't know, but let's give it a try. So, time for the silk. It states yellow. Light blue, sorry. So let me just get some light blue. I almost did a mistake there. It's 4 different silk in this pattern. Start with the light blue. So I'm just gonna tie it in using the material to even up. Since we have, I tied in the gilt substitute. And that always gives a bump in the body, so I'm leveling out using the material. So tight wraps backwards. The body. That also means that the flag will be more robust if you intend to fish with it. So Going backwards again. Now we have a bit of a bump down here, so I'm just gonna even that one out with the thread. A little bit more. And there we are. So I'm gonna use a clear wax. And then it's time for the tail. Making sure it's just on top of everything. Yeah, centered. So then I just tie the whole piece in. There we go. Backward again. Find some more bikes. I'm gonna attach an acrylic substitute. In the whole piece. There we are. Then I'm gonna change to black wax. I'm gonna tie in the ostrich hair. Applying some pressure, then waxing more of the thread, just to be ready to tie the ostrich hull in. I'm just gonna see how it turns. Dry and awful. I should really use the new one I colored. Yeah, maybe I do that. So I just remove this one. So let's see how this one works. Oh. That one decided to move direction. few wraps with the thread. And there we are. So. This one is very, very soft. Really fragile. So just tying that one in. Just put some pressure on the ostrich shell to push it backwards. So next one, going back again with the thread. Silver twist. Sorry. So I tie that one in. Same here, I'm using the tinsel to flatten out the body. Flat silver tinsel. Just gonna get that out of the way. Oh, next step, yellow. So there's two different yellows in this one. So I'm gonna go with a very light yellow and then the normal yellow. Let me tie this one in as well. Same here, tying it in underneath. Tight wraps backwards. And then forward again. And then just keep an eye on the thickness. And somewhere here we're gonna add the body hackle. I think I'm gonna tie in the body hackle here. Mm-hmm.
Let's see how that works. Somebody hackle yellow. Let me first just prepare the feather. I didn't have time to double it before I started, so I'm gonna do that now. And that means that I'm gonna pull the feathers above, below, sorry. Lost the grip there. Take a bit of time. Everything in just to make sure it's robust, and then I continue with the silk. Just making sure the level of the body is looking good. Change color. There's nothing in regards to veiling or more ostrich shell, so I'm just gonna go with the silk. So it's moving forward a bit. Take the next color of silk, it's a golden yellow. Just gonna have a look so I don't miss anything. Oh, looks good. So I'm trying this piece in. So, time for this nice yellow. Tight wraps as always. Backwards and then forward. Trying to make a nice even body. Almost there. Close one. So just securing this one. There we go. Next step. I'm gonna borrow a bit of that. Light green. This is the best one I could find. Just gonna cut the leftovers here. And then put the thread where I want it. So. Looks okay. So I'm just gonna continue working on the body volume a bit. So I'm just gonna cut the leftover silk. And then the fun part starts. Tinsel and body häckel. So first I go with the flat tinsel. Just gonna make sure I don't tie in any fibers. Yeah. making sure that the following just behind the flat silver tinsel. No, heckle time. Same here. So what we're gonna do is to pull all the fibers backwards. We're gonna follow behind the tinsel. Sorry. Just a few turns to secure the stem of the hackle. There we go. So I'm just gonna tie in that and secure it. We have a really nice body. Looking good. Front tackle light green. We're gonna take something in between, I think. This one is I think it's gonna become lighter when I add it to the hook. Yeah, it's gonna be light green for sure. So in anything else than the front tackle. pulling the fiber backwards. And there we go. Front tackle in place. So I'm just gonna cut the stem off. There we go. A few wraps with the thread to secure everything. Next step then. Oh, it's just a wing smack on. So I'm gonna build the wing. And then we, there's no middle wing, so we are just gonna attach it. So I just made the wing. Just straightforward. So I'm just gonna pair them. As well. Yeah. So I'm just gonna work on the angle of the wing a bit. Even it up in the back. Thank you. the gully. I'm just gonna center it. In a way, alone. So, next step. So, we're gonna have tea, bronze mallard, and topping. Let's see where we can find all the nice tea. So I need to prepare the teal for tie-in as well. I'm gonna start with my side. It's curving a bit. Now it's better, as you can see. So I just need to find some teal for the other side. Good as well. Hard to find good. Need to find a good source of tea. I think I have to go with this one. garbage feather. So throwing that away, I need to find something else. It's gonna be tricky. Didn't prepare any good feathers for the purpose. They're just fluffy. Not really the material you wanna tie into a fly. Crap. So let's see what we got in my big material drawer. I remove that one. Here we have some stuff. Let's see what we can do with that. There we go. It will slip up. The good thing, we're gonna put mullard on top of it. We can marry them together. Didn't really end up where I wanted it. Let's have a look again. Mm-hmm. Now it's better. I'm okay with that. So let's do the other side. There we go. So I'm just gonna pull it down a bit. Not really nice here though. Better. Yeah, I'm on a time schedule. Two videos today. So just removing this one. I'm just gonna apply a bit of wax there, and then we have a topping. And just a black head. Topping time! So, let's find the topping. But before I tie in the topping, I will clean the head there. Just want to size one up. Big. Big, 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 big. A few more. Straighten it out a bit. There we have one. So we have found the topping. So I'm just gonna cut everything off and then start with the topping, and then we're almost done. Thank you. look at this one. There's a few fibers I'm gonna remove. So let's see what happens. Looks okay. Nice fall. So I'm just gonna tie it in properly, wax the thread, and then the fly is done.
So that's how you tie the springtime pattern in the back of a Pryce Tannat book. Not Pryce Tannat pattern, but it's in there. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm gonna shoot a picture and then start to prepare for my live tying on YouTube. So see you in the next video.